didn't get scammed. I'm here. You didn't get scammed.
Uh-oh. No, 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 no. Don't tell me I have to change servers again. Don't even do that.
I just turned it on.
Don't even tell me I have to change servers. Come on, man. We'll see. You know, every couple weeks I have to change my Twitch server because I don't know. It doesn't like where my connection's coming from, apparently. But hello, how are you? Good to see you. What's up? I'm doing good. Talk about baseball? Wait, we're gonna get to that. Let me wait to disappoint everybody. Give them a few minutes to come and sit down. Eating any olives today? Yeah, of course, I eat olives every day. Talk about your Roblox server. I don't have one of those. Make me a cake. That's the point. That's what we're going to try to do today. Don't leak. Don't leak. People are already leaking the bad news for baseball. Don't leak. Don't leak. All right. No, it's not time yet. I had a wild 6 or 7 days. Did the Brio cart thing with Ludwig, which was a ton of fun. I didn't think I could drink that many beers. I really didn't. You guys didn't really get to see that much of the beer drinking, but holy shit. I've never drank beer faster in my whole life. We almost won, too. When we got to Rainbow Road, it's just like, I can't do Rainbow Road. I can't do Rainbow Road sober. I can't do Rainbow Road at all. I would skip that level. In fact, I would stop playing Mario Kart at that kind of, what is it, the Star Cup, whatever? No, I don't feel like it. I don't want to play that. I don't want to play that part of the game. But that was fun. Then this whole Mr. Beast versus Ninja tournament. That was crazy too. Got to hang out with a lot of people. It was a lot of fun. I wish more people would come to Vegas. It's so much fun when people come here. Rainbow Road is easy. What'd you say? I want to see what this person said. Rainbow Road is easy, you just need skills. No. It's not easy. You lost 10,000 at 10k at the game. No, I did not. I did not lose 10k at the casino. Which Rainbow Road? Aren't they all the same exact course from when it first showed up in Super Nintendo? It's the same one, right? Do they change it? Why would they change it? They don't even need to change it. It was 20k. Where are you getting this idea that I lost $20,000 at a casino? Who told you this? It was 30k. Well, the number keeps going up, so whatever. We know. No, it was awesome. It was really fun. Anytime a bunch of streamers come into Vegas and I ever have an opportunity, I'm just like, oh, come to Vegas. All right. You'll be in Vegas? Really? What are you up to? Hey, what are you doing? It's always a lot of fun. You live in... Why do you live in Vegas? Because, Matt. You know what I mean? That's it. I don't... Okay, I'm gonna get... I'll do it slow this time. Why do you live in Vegas? Because, I mean... Come on. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? That's why. Oh, it's close to LA, but you don't have to pay LA prices. It's only 45 minutes in a plane to LA. The real estate market out here is way, way cheaper than some of these other places. There's no state tax in Nevada. Isn't that interesting? There's also lots of entertainment. There's so much stuff to do here. 24, do I have to do this whole thing every few months? Do I have to do this every few months? Every act trick. Taxes? I didn't move here just because of the tax, the state taxes not being a thing. I mean, it was... I mean, you know, alright. But that's not why I'm here. Again, it's close to LA. I don't have to pay LA prices. 45 minutes... Wheels up, wheels down. The real estate market is at... I'm not doing this anymore. What happened to the mystery game? Every single stream is a mystery game. I figure out what I'm going to do 10 minutes before the stream turns on. Every day is a mystery. Besides the event streams. Like baseball. By the way. Got something to talk about with baseball. So, okay, enough people are here, let's do it. So baseball is supposed to be on the 24th of July. I told you the last time I streamed, it was kind of a sad moment. I said, we're trying really hard to get stuff to work. We've had some venue problems, and I was given the opportunity to either do it in a different place that would kind of suck, that's not what I want, or push it to August and do it where I want to do it and how I want to do it. So I said, okay, do you delay another few weeks, another month or so, right? And do what I actually want to do, or keep the same date and do it in a different venue, potentially in a scenario that I didn't want to do it in. And of course, I'm going to pick the one that I want to do. So we're going to do it in August. Thankfully, it does not have to be in October or November or something, so we're good. And also, here's another good thing about this. There's a couple things that I may have wanted to do that I didn't have enough time to prepare for it if it was in a week that now I can add into the show. So it's going to be a better show now overall, because there's a couple things I get to put in it now that I may have had to cut for time. So, I hope I don't sound like a broken record here, but August 19th is the new date for the baseball show. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, I am 90% confident in that date. I don't think it's possible at this point for it to be not that date. If it's not that date, then I'm doing it in my backyard. You know what I mean? Like, I'll do it in a backyard, right? Only 90%. This stream is going to happen before the summer ends, okay? That's what I can 100% guarantee to you. Delay, yeah, delays. I know. But here's the thing. If I don't delay the show, think about it. If the show were to be next week, And it's, I mean, look, it's going to be good. I am so excited to do this. I've been looking forward to this for like 2 years. It's going to be fun, regardless of where it is or how the things that I want go, right? But why not do the thing you wanted to do? The thing that you've been planning to doing? The thing that I've had written down on a piece of paper? Well, that makes it sound like it's on the back of a fucking napkin. The thing that I have spent... yeah, I wrote down two sentences. No, the thing that I've had sitting in various documents over the last few years of shit that I really want to do. And I'm going to do the thing I want to do. And that's all there is to it. 2022, not 20... No, not 2023. What are you talking about? Are Grotto Beast NFTs? No. No, 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 no. No. Stop asking. No. No, they're not. No. No, 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 no. Clip any of those. No, 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 any one of those will do. Clip any one of those. They're physical. We got two raids right at the beginning. Wait, one Kit Boga just came in with a raid. What's up, Kit? Hope you had a good stream. Kit Boga. Thanks, welcome, guys. Hope you had a good stream. I'm starting pretty early today, huh? Hey, guess what? Starting early tomorrow, too. Are you ready for this, EU? All the EU people here? Let me tell you something. Tomorrow, you ready? Tomorrow's stream is going to be at 11 a.m. Pacific. Do you understand? 11 o'clock in the morning, Pacific. I love EU. 11 a.m. Pacific. I love EU. Usually once a year. No, but thanks, Kit. Also, Sagi with a raid too. Welcome everybody from Sagi's channel. Hope I'm saying that right. Thanks for the raid. And yeah, Kit Boga. Fuck yeah. I feel like it's been a month since I streamed. It's only been a week. But why am I streaming at 11 o'clock in the morning tomorrow? There's a sponsor stream tomorrow.
Ooh, okay. What is it?
Tomorrow, I am going to be playing... Power Washer Simulator. That's right. Hell yeah. Let's go. I love that fucking game. Sponsored by water. That's not going to be the only thing we do tomorrow. We'll play another game or two as well, but starting at 11 o'clock in the morning. You should get sponsored by Sig. What? People, I don't know what it is recently, the last, like, I don't know, month or two. Oh, what's the cigarette thing? Is that a thing I'm missing somehow? All right, let's go. Today we're gonna play Bakery Simulator. Bakery Simulator. Is this made by the same people that did Cooking Simulator? Is it the same people? Are you gonna do a raid song? Guys, it's not 2018. We don't do raid songs anymore. Is it by the same people? I think you can drive around. From the trailer, it looks like there's a car in this game. So, it gets an automatic A. Starts at A. And let's go. You guys ready? Good. What's up? Why is it asking me if I want my Nintendo Switch? What? Okay. Hi. How you doing? I know, your cam sucks, your cam's blurry. Ralph? Oh, whatever. All right, so should I do the tutorial? Should I figure out how to, do I know how to play this already? I'm just gonna do it. You're all orange. You look like an orange. I don't care. Everything is in PST. That's right, I'm in PST. I also figured out too, I don't know what it is about this camera, but I looked at the images from the last stream too. This makes my head go like this. It makes my forehead and head look way taller and bigger. I don't know why it's doing that. What lens does that? Do you see what I mean? I have this big forehead with this camera. I don't look like this. Oh, I was off the, what was the loading time? All right. Welcome to your bakery. Your biggest dream came true. You opened your very own bakery and you're ready to flood the city with fresh pastries. However, it's just the beginning. A lot of hard work ahead of you. Build reputation, gain experience, and become successful in the world of baking. There's a lot of responsibilities, but don't... This is a guitar, is kind of... I don't know, it's something about it. There's a lot of responsibilities, but don't worry, you'll make it. After all, this is all you've dreamed of. Your first order is waiting for you. This is just bad ratatouille. You have not played it. You don't know that. Okay, WASD, that's gotta change for sure. Is this a piano or is this a guitar? Is it, no wait, this is the guitar setting on the piano. No, this input's too high. That's the lowest I can do. Please tell me it's all right. All right, that's better. All right, go to the ordering board and press left mouse on the folder. All right, ordering board, left mouse, folder. There it is, got it, open. 5 minute bakery, 3 breakfast bun. Is that the road? I don't know why I thought that was like 3 breakfast bun road, because I saw this. Whoops, okay. This is how you're going to start your work from now on. Okay, so it takes 5 minutes. On the left is a list of shops with current orders. Now only one order is available, okay. But later in the game, you'll be able to pick more than one request from a much longer list, all right. That's a map with marked shops. Based on it, you can check the location of orders. You can decide what part of the city you want to make a delivery to. All right, so you drive around in this game. Are you wearing a wig? You'll make it up if I say no anyways. All right, pick the available order and press confirm. So this one here. After selecting an order, it will appear the ordering board. Press to on the board. All right, so this is the order. 3 breakfast buns. But before you move further, let me teach you about the recipe book. Okay. To open the, okay, press tab. Is this by the house flipper people? This menu looks very similar. Okay. So where's the recipe book? There. Wig. Select the recipe book now. Here are all the recipes that you already know. Right now, it's not that much, but don't worry. With every new level, you'll learn new ones. Bookmarks on the side make navigation easier. Where's my... There it is. That looks like a lot of information. That's a lot of info. That's a ton of steps. Okay, this is gonna... I don't wanna do this. Each recipe page contains information about the steps required to prepare the order, as well as ingredients, mixing time, ingredients, and baking time. You can stop tracking it. Oh, it's like a quest log. All right. You should recreate this on stream. No, I don't like the smell of eggs. I like the way eggs taste. I don't like the smell of raw eggs. After you crack a raw egg, and if it just sits out there for more than 1 to 2 minutes, I hate that smell of raw egg that is not, like, gone away from me. There's no eggs in this? Do you guys know what I'm talking about, though? I don't like baking because it just... flour and eggs, it has this weird, off-putting kind of essence to it. I really don't like it. It's weird. You know what? Some of you guys get it. You don't smell the eggs. No, you don't. I'm not smelling them. All right, I'm trying to play. Okay, you can choose the number of products to bake by yeah. Okay, use the arrows. The recipe will adjust accordingly. Oh, okay. Cool. Checklist is visible on the right. So this is how to make the breakfast buns. Follow the recipe and complete it perfectly. Cooking is not a science, man. Come on. 6 ounces of wheat flour. I could do 5. 2.4 fluid ounces of water. You could do 2. Milk. Just don't even put it in because milk is gross. Yeast. Extra yeast. I want 1 ounce of yeast. And then I want... By the way, don't do that. You like milk and flour is like, incredibly important in all these recipes, so don't be an idiot. All right, let's do some baking. Bowl. This bowl is the average and small, but don't worry. During the game, you'll be able to unlock bigger and more professional bowls. Okay. That's what I do in the kitchen. I'm here for like, I'm like the comic relief. All right, so now what? Oh. Time to collect the needed ingredients. Go to the ingredients rack. Let's go. So I need wheat flour. Something on fire. Oh. I don't like that. Is that what it is? I feel like that's dangerous. What if you walk by and you like get your pant leg catches on fire? This is not controlled enough for me. All right. Ingredients rack. Where is that? Over here? Okay. In the bottom left corner of the screen, you can find the scoops. What? For now, you just need a 1 gram scoop. Click the ingredients by clicking. Where's my scoop? Bottom left of the screen. You guys see any scoops? Okay. Every time you're using the scoop or pressing and holding left mouse, the spoon will refill itself one by one. All right, so... How much do I need? This is butter. Pure creamy butter. Is this even in the recipe? What do I need? Where's my scoops? Pick up the bowl. Oh. I was gonna put my hand in it. Yeah, that looks to be about 1 cup. Just let it go and a quarter of it is stuck to my sweaty hand. And I just have to like shake like this. All right, so now we go water. No, wheat flour. Where's that? Where's a flour? Okay, wheat flour. Scoop. Scoop it out. There's no butter in this recipe. Do you see butter? What? There's no butter in this recipe. Okay. Oopsie, look at the checklist. It seems you've added the wrong ingredient. What will you do now? This is what I've just was saying the whole time. What are you talking about? What do I do now? By the way, anytime you make a mistake, you will see the exclamation point icon. Okay. Don't worry. This mistake can be fixed easily. Why is it all over me? It's literally all over me. You can remove only the last ingredient by pointing on the ingredient container. Oh, that's actually pretty helpful. Okay. Right click. It's still in there. It's still in the bowl. This is... Did I sneeze into this bowl? Why is it like this? Did I put a bunch of ingredients in here just like... All right, what? There's still butter in here. In the bowls, you can move them by using like a... Wait, hold on, I gotta read this slowly. Cool. But what to do when more than one ingredient in the bowl is wrong? Throw them in the trash. Okay. Okay, now move to the trash. Who puts butter in a bowl like this? Guys. Fucking children don't even do it like that. This was sprayed out of a jokey clown seltzer bottle. Children don't do this. Okay. Where's the trash? Where's the trash? Is there a trash? Oh, okay. It's still in there. Okay, with this message, you get rid of the entire content of the bowl. You can also use the trash to throw away other things. I don't fucking look like this. I swear to God. I don't look like this. I swear to God, I don't look like this image. I truly don't. Fucking pepperoni forehead? Guys, I don't look like that. I'm unplugging this camera. This camera is fucking messed up. You have a massive... No, I don't... There's pictures of me! There are pictures of me on the internet! I don't look like this. There are pictures of me on the internet. I don't look like this. My face has been, like, stretched 50% this way. I don't look like this. What? No, that's okay. I was gonna say there's no fucking way. No, okay, you guys are fucking with all these. I look like if they ever remade Frankenstein, right? This is like a new age Frankenstein. This is like Frankenstein in high school or something, right? This would be like the Christopher Nolan Frankenstein. Frankenstein's monster, Frankenstein. Yeah, whatever. You don't care. All right, let's go back to what we were doing, please. Yeah, I don't know. Some cameras are just fucked up. What were we doing? Oh, yeah. Right. Okay. Use the trash bin to throw away... People are playing tic-tac-toe on my forehead. That's fine. 10 times smarter than everybody in this room. You know what fits right here? Hey, what's the part of your brain? What's the part of your... I don't give a shit. We're gonna pause for a minute. This part where your forehead is, right here, what's in there? Your frontal cortex, right? That's hearing. That's math. That's knowledge. That's baking, right? That's everything. What's in there? Hearing. What's in your frontal lobe? What is it? Useless shit? What goes right here? Hearing is the only thing. It's personality and shit. Come on, man! That's where the funny noises come from. My brain probably looks. There's probably just this big mass in the front, and then it's just squished down and flat in the middle and down at the end. It's your whole personality. All right, let's go. All right, you can throw anything away. Who cares? Let's get back to baking. Look at the ingredients rack. It seems that one of the ingredients you need is missing. Don't worry. This is where all the baking supplies tab in the radial menu comes from. All right, so put this down. Put the bowl down. All right, so let's do the radial menu and select baking supplies. This is I thought this was a chessboard. The baking supplies tab is where you can buy missing ingredients. Okay. Choose the missing product. I need wheat. Okay. Purchase products don't immediately arrive to your bakery. Usually you have to wait for the delivery to get to them. This can be a little troublesome. Yeah. However, you can speed up the delivery. Be careful, it may cost you. Press U on wheat flour. What? Oh, okay. Do I have to use gems for this? Thank God. This one simple trick, which will help you avoid paying for a faster delivery or waiting for ingredients to arrive, just buy all the missing products before choosing an order. Being prepared for the day will save you some money. Good. Good. Okay. Well, now what? It's time to start. What's wrong with me? What happened? Am I donating blood right now? What's going on? What's going on here? Okay. You can collect the ingredients every time you use the scoop. Alright, the edibles are not kicking in. I haven't taken one. I think I'm getting... Somebody's just playing music in my ears. This is why I don't listen. Do you have your voice playing on a delay? No. What blood type am I? I have no idea. You know, that's actually kind of hard to figure out if you don't already know it. You have to specifically request that they do that. If you get blood taken and you ask, hey, so what's my blood type? They'll go, I don't know. They have to actually go look for that. You can't, they won't just tell you. How big is the wingspan that you have? I don't know, 15 feet? Maybe 16 feet? All right, you can collect the ingredient by clicking yes. All right, so let's go. What do I need? Into the bowl. There's still butter in this bowl. Can I rinse it? Whatever, I don't care. All right, we need, I want ounces. So wheat flour. Can I, use a big spoon. What the fuck am I doing this for? Just get a shovel. All right, 4 ounces of flour. Get it in there. And then 2 ounces of flour. Get it in there. All right, we have 6 ounces of flour in this bowl. We need yeast, 2.24 ounces of yeast. So this is that, and then 0.2. Got it. 0.24. We need milk. Full fat milk? Yuck. 2.4. All right, do that again. We're going to do 2.4. Bingo. We need water. Okay, water. 2.4 water. Good. Sugar. Okay. 0.12 ounces. Okay. Good job. Now you can mix the ingredients. Where? Transfer the dough to the mixer by press. Oh, okay. Here we go. Press. Did I do it? All right. Everything's in there. Press the button on the mixer casing and wait for the dough to be ready. Watch the widget carefully. You don't overmix the batter. Upgrade the machine? It's almost done! Check. No, it's almost done! It's gonna overmix! I can't wait 7 seconds for this? Okay, so turbo mode. What? I thought you don't want to mix things quickly. Sometimes don't you need it to do. You don't want it to be that. Alright, be careful. How do I do a turbo mode? Hey, hey! Turn it off, turn it off, turn it off, turn it off! Okay. Take the bowl back, put the dough on the forming board. What's up? Is this a forming board? Buns are formed with bare hands. Put down the bowl on the table in the middle of the bakery. Okay. With my bare hands? There are various forms of pastries, from long bread to croissant. As you gain more and more experience, you will learn how to create different forms. But for now, let's just do a bun, okay? It's like buns. Dividing dough is the first minigame. Wait for the indicator to reach the green area and press space. That was fucking perfect. Literally right in the middle, exactly 50%. Okay. Form the dough is the second minigame. Grab the ring and move the mouse to match the images with their shadows. What? Grab the ring and move the images with their shadows. Form the buns. What? Oh. Now put the freshly formed buns on the tray. I keep thinking the restaurant is on fire. It keeps freaking me out. Okay, do this. Grab and hold the tray. Put it down. Oh, grab. Okay, wait, I can do it from the tray. I get it. Okay. Bake your buns. However, you have just an old oven for now. Don't worry, you'll acquire better ovens later. Open the oven door. This is so scary. I don't know how we've come to determine that this is just a normal thing to have just in people's houses and shit. I'm serious. Okay. There's no timer on this oven. I thought you're not supposed to open it. Boost? What is this doing? Holy shit, is that okay? Ah, my hands! Why is there a boost button? Find the delivery crate. Next to the door. The amount of delivery crates is always determined by the number of orders you picked up on the current day. Alright, so this is a delivery crate? Is he live? Yeah. What do you mean, is this live? Yeah. What are you talking about? How the... Those are not delivery crates? Where's a delivery crate? Oh, because the tutorial locks me out. Okay, each delivery crate has... Each delivery crate has the client's logo on the side to help you identify the correct crate. This one is going to be delivered in two... I thought it would be delivered in 5 minutes. Okay. Okay. Where's the delivery crate? It said the crate's by the door. Is this a crate? Which one of these is closer to the door? The crates by the door. Oh yeah, just go to the crates by the door. That's not by the door, that's by the oven. Okay. Put the tray back on the counter. Now last step, time to prepare the buns for delivery. Pick up the crate and place it in the orange highlight in the blue area. Crate will then be moved to the delivery car. Ooh. Remember that later in the game, you'll be able to stack crates on top of each other to deliver to multiple orders. Now the order is ready for delivery. Move to the door and press to do it. Let's deliver the food. Here you can choose which order you want to deliver. You've got only one order available, so we're already picked it for you. Press the move to city button. This is one, yeah, this is a one-man operation. This is not the end of your task. Delivering the orders is an important is as important as preparing them. During this part of your job, you have to be as fast as possible. Remember to watch the timer in the top of the screen. This is crazy taxi with buns. Later in the game, you'll be able to hire a courier to deliver the orders for you. In the bottom left corner, you can see a mini-map that will help you navigate through the city streets. To check the whole view of the area, you can open the city map. I didn't do anything, I'm already in trouble. Open the radial menu? Call for a delay. Okay. Reset position, decline. Oh, I can just cancel the order? How come your ears are twitching? I don't know. Okay, WASD. Spacebar. Why is this original GTA? Where am I going? Oh, right here. Holy shit, this guy's on. That was 30 minutes or less. Deliver. What happens if you crash? I don't know. I don't want to fail the tutorial. What the fuck did I just do? All right, time to take a little break from baking. You know what's always fun? Makeovers. It's time for the bakery to get a renovation. Okay, customization tab. Point at the main table and press the... Okay. Tables. Is this not the main table? Is this wrong? It's time for you to do a makeover scene. Which one of these is the main table? This is a main table. Should I just bought that? You just completed your first order. Don't forget what you've learned. It will be useful in your further experience as a baker. Good luck. Oh shit. Nice. All right, let's go. I got $1 million. I forget everything. All right, over here. Do you want to check orders and start a new day? Wait, not yet. I gotta get ready. Am I ready? Am I ready? Yeah, all right. I just wanna make sure I have everything. All right, let's go. Okay, I thought I could just drive around. All right, let's do it. It's time for a new day. We need one bronze bed. Bronze bread. Here we go. All right, I got 8 minutes to do this. Okay. Close the map. Get the fucking map. I don't want to leave the restaurant. Stay. Okay, get off. Oh, that's what I'm looking at. All right, let's go. Go. What do I need? Where's the recipe? Recipe book. All right, just track this. Whatever, I don't care. How do I track that? Track it. Track this. I need one. Track it. Okay, let's go. Bowl. Rye flour. How much do I need? 1.2 pounds. That's a lot. Pounds? That's a shitload of flour. Okay, 12 ounces of water. How much is a pound? What is a pound of water? Oh, wait, hold on. 8, 12? What is a pound of water? 2 fluid ounces of olive oil. Okay. Any milk in this? 0.2 of yeast. What happened? I can't put any more stuff in here. Where, yeast, 0.2 ounces of yeast. Good. Okay, salt. 0.2 of salt. Oh, that's sea salt. 0.08 of sugar. Okay. How's that wrong? How do I put the sugar back? Okay, we're good. Now we need to do 30 to 50 seconds in the machine. Go. Why does it sound like an old car? Alright, then we have to form it. Okay, form it. Alright, put this down. Go. What is it called? Bronze bread. What is this? No, that's not right. That's not right. That's wrong. How do I do this? Is that correct? Is it round bread? Is it brown? Bronze bread? Oh shit, oops. Just one? What fucking weird person ordered one of these? All right, go. Turbo. What? 300, how many, can I tell the degrees of the oven? Me? Come on! I only have 5 minutes to do this. Steam-powered Andy. Holy shit, oh my god, that actually looks pretty good. That looks really good. Guys, the floor is cleaner than my hands, okay? Trust me. So now where's this going? Did I order it myself? No, wait, what? Am I cooking the books and making fake business for myself? What am I doing? Can I get a better camera angle with the car? Why are there roadblocks? Wait, 8 a.m. Nope. That's good. All right, deliver. Right on time. Did I just make six? That's it? I'm saying that's it. $60 for one piece of bread seems a little absurd. All right, cool. I got 1,060. Wait, should I clean up? No wonder it's like 80 degrees or 90 degrees in here. Do I have to clean up or is it just, that's it? Okay, two golden bread. You got it. I think I'm pretty good at this. Recipe book. Golden bread. Oh, wait a minute, I have to make two of these now. All right, two, track two. That's very helpful. 2.5 pounds of flour. Let's get it. 1.2. What is it? Wheat flour? All right. 2.5 pounds. 1 pint of water. Is that one pint? How much is a pint? Is 1.25 pounds a pint? No. How much is a pint? What's a pint? Why would I be scooping this up with one of these scoopers? I need 1 pint of water. What is 1 pint of water? How many ounces is a pint? No, don't speak in milliliters. I'm American. 16 ounces is a pint? Okay. Thank you. 8 ounces of milk. 8 ounces of salt. Oh no. 8 ounces of 0.56 of salt. That's 0.04. 0.56. Okay. 0.4 is sugar. I got 20 minutes to do this. I'm fine. Wait, what? Uh-oh. We're good. All right, 0.48 of yeast. Okay. All right, 30 seconds in here. Do the other bread while you wait. There's no order for it. Oh, wait, I'm doing this for too long, aren't I? All right, we're good. All right, this is golden bread. What kind of bread is this? There's too much air in this. What kind of bread is it? Is this a round bread? Or is this a, what kind of bread is it? Is it a long bread? Okay. Go! Okay. I feel like this is a captcha. Oh, you're better than 95% of all other players. Which, by the way, I don't know how long it's taking some people to do that shit, but even if you do it wicked slow and you're deliberately trying to make it so you're doing it as slow as possible, you still apparently have done that faster than like 65% of the population. I don't how. You can't let this get light on fire, right? I can't wait to open this and be like, hits me in the head. Let's go. Ooh. Any more orders? No, that's it. All right, let's go. Why are you so red? I'm filled with blood. All right, can I get a better view of this car? There's gotta be like a better like car view, right? I don't want this like GTA camera. Is there a better view? Inputs. Okay, character mode, character actions. Mini games, cut dough, car movement. Change truck camera, V. Okay, hold on. That doesn't work. C. I just drove by it. I can't see the little things in front of me. Okay. I'm starting to get the hang of it. I think the game's gonna start to get a little more difficult now. Alright. Two old-fashioned loaves and three golden breads. And this is going across town. Okay, I got 20 minutes. Let's go. Alright, three... Wait. Wait. No, wrong. This is, okay, three golden bread. No, it's okay. I was making sure I was tracking three. All right, wheat flour, 3 points pounds. Got it. Water, 1.5 pounds. Okay, milk, 12 ounces of milk. 0.84 ounces of salt. Okay. Sugar. It's alright. To do it again. It's alright. We're good. Okay. 0.72 of yeast. Good. I'm gonna try to. I'm gonna get the other stuff going too. Alright. Get this started. Let's do the other one. Can I not make the other one? How do I make the other one? Can I only do one at a time? Do I not have the capability to do more than one right now? Cheese, what? Where? Get it. All right, three golden breads. All right, let's make this quick. That's not three. There's only two. Why is it only two? Move! Alright, get it. 20 minutes. Okay, can I start another one? You're smart, you just don't know object permanence. I mean, I know object permanence, but not really. It just, it doesn't stay there. Okay, things like, well, if I put something down, it's hard to remember where I put it. Which is object permanence. Fuck, I could dodge an axe if you're swinging at me. I don't give a shit. Alright, so now what? I have 20 minutes to do this? Ooh, those look good. Alright, they're not ready yet. Now we're gonna do the other one. Okay. So this one's ready. Oh shit. I have to come back and do it. Why would I do that? This oven can fit 10 pizzas in it. Why would I not do all these deliveries at the same time? Why am I doing only 3 pieces of bread at once? What a waste of energy. Where's my buy tool? Whatever. Let's go. I don't know why I keep thinking about this. Oh, dude, what's the baseball stream? Oh, he's gonna shove a whole baseball up his ass. Like, at that person that asked the question. You know how many times I've thought about that comment? Do I even know where this is? I just lost a tire. Oh yeah, guys, sorry, I got a delay. Oh, there's tons of preparation I gotta do. Oh, what are you doing? Oh, why, he's shoving a baseball up his ass. How do I even get over this other road? Dude, I don't want to drive like this. Why can I not be at third person angle? What is this? Where is this bridge? Oh. Can I get a faster car? Eventually. Holy shit, that was cool. Are the cops after me? I'm still unsure of what's going on with that. Yep. This is a far away delivery. Is this the last possible place to deliver that's on the edge of the whole entire world here? This is the last possible place to take this. Donut dude. All right, donut dude. What do I got, $150? All right, let's go. My stomach hurts. Sip on a little bit of ginger ale. Just a little. Very small sips. I have to do a new day. That's okay. Come on, man. Alright, this one's right down the street and it pays the same amount of money. Why would I ever do the other one? Wait, how do I upgrade? $600 for what? I just changed the finish of the wood. Oh, it's everywhere. Okay. I actually prefer the other one. Alright, let's get started. Come on. It was bronze bread, right? How many? 3 bronze breads. 3.75 pounds of rye flour. 2.5 pints. So that's din 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 din. No. Din. Olive oil. 6 ounces of olive oil. Is it actually olive oil? I guess there would be, yeah. Alright, 0.6 of yeast. What happened? Okay, that thing would have came alive. Salt. Sugar.
More. More.
What the fuck is this? What? Who delivered the Willy Wonka candy machine? What is this thing? All right, free bronze bread. Free. I can't say it. Excuse me? What's happening here? What happened? Fucking go! What's this, brown bread? Yeah. Toy boat check? Okay, yeah. That's right. toy boat. Oh, it's close. I got it. Pretty close. That's the wrong way. This game's pretty chill. Oh, Undertale. Where'd it go? What happened? Oh, it's over there. The music. It sounded like Undertale. Do I have to? Come on. Dun, 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 dun. Come on. I'm not fighting you on this one. It's not even close. Come on, that's like the dog theme, right? I'm kidding. Holy smokes. Ooh, look at this. Don't you feel like that you would take this piece of bread and you would go like... It would make... You'd be like... You can't bite it. And you just put it down. And then somebody would come over with a big ass knife. And it would be like... I like the middle. Everyone out here trying to be the next ball fondler. Yeah. Yeah, sorry, man. You're just gonna get timed out for... You know what I mean? People out here trying to, you know, follow that trend of what ball fondler said. It's, man. There, by the way, mods, why that comment is strange, because there is no turkey baster. There's nothing here. This is not a turkey baster, where? Show me the turkey baster. Okay, 3 silver loaf or 4 golden bread. This one, because it's right down the street and it's $200. What is he talking about? I'm talking about the crazy things that people say in this chat. All right, so what are we doing here? What do I need? 4, right? 4. So can I pull it up? All right, recipe book, let's go. All right, 4 puppet bread. What the hell is that? What was it, bronze bread? I don't remember. What is it? 4 golden bread, okay. Let's go. All right, come on. 5 pounds of wheat flour. Whole meal flour, what? What's wrong? What? Is it empty? How do I buy more? Oh, it's empty. How do I buy more? Deliver it now. How much did that cost me? Is that too much? I don't care. How much is in here? Five. Yeah, we're good. All right, 2 pints of water. 1 pint of milk. This is almost... I can't fit any more in this bowl. Salt. Sourdough comes out of a can? What? Okay, salt. A lot. That's a lot of salt. Shit. How much do I need? What? Sorry, I bullfrogged for a second. Alright, 0.8. And then 0.96 of yeast. This is just bullshit, to be honest. 0.96. Just, it's 1 ounce. It's 1 ounce. Does it really have to be exact? Okay. Put it in here. I have not even turned this machine on. I don't think it has to be exact. Stop using Imperial. I have to use Imperial. I would not be able to do it the other way. What is this? This long bread, right? I hope. Do it! When are we gonna get new emotes? Here's when you're gonna get new emotes. I say every 6 months that new emotes are coming. And I haven't added a new emote since 2018. So... just take that, I guess, with how... take that how you will. We just put it on BTTV, you know what I mean? It just goes on better Twitch TV. Boost. Does that hurt everybody's ears? Is it bad? Upgrade the oven. Oh my god. A good old simple oven can bake up to 2 oven trays. Why can't I upgrade it? I just own it. Can I replace it? I don't think I can replace it. You? I pressed you. That's me pressing you to open that submenu. Alright. First person to get this right gets a pretend gold star. What song is this? Let's do it. Ready? What song is it? Mods, keep track of your programs. I wonder who gets this first. I'm not doing it again. They're fine. Alright, I'm gonna say it. There was a Stone Cold Steve Austin intro song. Did anybody get it? Anybody get it? Who said it? Who got it? See, in my brain, how did you not get that? To me, that is such an iconic piece of musical medley that there's no way you would not have gotten that. Dun 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 dun. Nothing else sounds like that. By the way, do you guys think that the person that makes all the WWF, WCW, whatever theme songs, that person has more, they've made so many iconic pieces of music. Right? Think about that. Some of the most recognizable tunes ever created were made by the WWE music composer guy. Don't you feel like they deserve a lot more credit? You think the guy that made the Undertaker's theme song sits around going, that's one of the most recognizable, that's the Super Mario of music. Like, seriously. I think he deserves a little more credit. It's not one guy. Well, it's a, I don't know, group. Who makes it? That's the most boomer shit I've ever heard in my life. Okay. Back up. If I played for you the first 10 seconds of Do You Smell What the Rock is Cooking? And then 10 seconds of whatever music is popular right now, how many people would recognize the Rock's theme song versus something that is like popular kind of right now? How many humans on Earth would recognize the Rock's theme song? And you tell me this is boomer shit. Relevancy bias? In 100 years. Is it really relevancy bias? Because I just told you right now, that Stone Cold theme song, Glass Break. You know what that song is immediately. Everybody. Trends come and go, artists come and go, but Stone Cold Steve Austin's theme song is forever. You will never forget it. I'm sorry, I feel like that's pretty iconic. 100 years from now, they'll know that. I don't know that. I don't. No. We didn't know. Literally, we couldn't do it. Yeah, but there's a difference between me going like... And you actually... There's a difference between... Hold on. Let's just fucking... You know what I'm saying? Don't make me do this. Don't make me... Okay, you ready? Here we go. How many people in chat know what this is? How many people in chat know what this is? I want to see it. Just shout it out when you get it. That's right. That's right. No, this is not the Home Depot theme song. This is... This is not Home Depot. This is not the Home Depot theme song. This is the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock. It sounds, all right, I can see how it does sound a little like Home Depot. It sounds a little like Home Depot. Oh, fuck, it is Home Depot. How dare you not know what this is and know what Home Depot is? You've been consumed by capitalism. You've been consumed by capitalism. This is Ken Shamrock's theme. This is not Home Depot theme song. This is Ken Shamrock, the world's most dangerous man. Okay. How about another one? Let's do this one. Who is this?
You know, it doesn't matter if you choose left or right, because they're both chewy, crunchy, and delicious.
You know, it doesn't matter if you choose left or right.
This is a Twix commercial. Twix is a gross.
Crunchy and delicious.
Okay. I'm kidding. I love these things. Oh, I'm not going to even play anymore. Who is that? What is that? Don't you dare say the Taco Bell fucking commercials. I'll be pissed. Don't you dare. I know. No, it's not Taco Bell. No, it's not. Leave the bun behind. It's not. You guys have been consumed by capitalism. I saw it already. Taco Bell, Taco Bell, Taco Bell. This is the goddamn Undertaker. Why does it have to be Taco Bell? It's not fair. Here it comes. Somebody said this is what they played at the Taco Bell Chihuahua's funeral. Oh my god, you guys are too much. Okay. How about this one? Now, excuse me, I don't care. I don't give a shit who you are, how old you are. Doesn't matter. If you guys, if this chat room does not become electric when I play this, I'm going to prove my point right now. And I'm going to wait till I know. I'm not even going to play the intro. If this room does not become electric when you hear this. Everyone spam it so I can prove my point. Let's see it. Spam it. What the fuck is happening right now? You gotta take a stand, it don't have to hide. Holy shit. This is not... What? That's Hulk Hogan's music. That's... The Hulkamania. What happened? Oh shit, I'm yelling at clouds again. Oh no. Jerma, we only know three wrestlers. Undertaker, John Cena. Dude, we're like 20 years old. Shit, you're right. Nobody cares, sorry. Oh, man. Okay. All right, I'll go make the bread again. Okay. I got one more for you. One more. Come on. Yeah, you guys should know this one, right? Let's see. Yeah, this is, I think, pretty popular wrestler. You guys should get this one. Come on, everybody knows this one. We don't know. We don't know. You don't know. Really? That's Glue Man's theme song from Jerma Rumble live action. I can't say I'm disappointed, but I am. Let's go bake bread. I have a shirt of that guy. Yeah. All right, let's go. I'm obviously too old. Fucking Home Depot theme song. That's seriously one of the funniest things I've ever heard in a long time. I want to take like a 5-minute break to go laugh about that in the bathroom. You know what I mean? Just sit there and just laugh in the bathroom, just like pissing. You know what I mean? I just want to laugh in the bathroom about that. 9 puppet buns? All right, sure. It's the Home Depot. Oh, Taco Bell, Home Depot. You guys are fucking hilarious. All right, where's my bowl? So wait, can I put 9 breads worth in here? I don't think so. 9. I need 11 pounds of flour. I need a bigger bowl. I can't do that, right? Yeah, I can't fit anything in here. I need a bigger bowl. How do I get a bigger... Where do I buy a bigger bowl? Baking supplies? Where's bowl? No, do not order everything. How do I get a bowl? Don't do it all at once. But I want to... I want to do it all at once. God damn it. All right. Does it really matter? I don't think you can fail missions in this game. I don't care. No, give that back. Give that back. That was 8 pounds of flour I threw in the trash. Shit, whatever. Oh my God. How much is it? Okay, 11.5. What's half 11.5? So, close enough. I don't care. Okay, water. 2.5. I need more water. Shit. Oh my fucking God. How big is this bowl? Why would I only have one bowl in this whole bakery? You've got to be kidding me. I have one bowl in the whole bakery. What was that? Go use the toilet bowl. I can't even... Give me this goddamn thing. Come here. Okay. Stop tracking. Let's do 2. These are gonna take forever! Alright, well, I'll do batches of 3, batches of 4. Can I fit that? I don't know. This can hold 8.5 pounds. Okay, 2 pints of water. 1 pint of milk. Salt. Okay, sugar. Yeast. Sesame? I don't think I... Oh, yeah. Okay, there it is. Sesame seeds. And when you put those on at the end... Why would these go on now? Into the gross, thick mixture? Wouldn't you put these in, like, at the very end when you bake them? I guess not. Oh, fuck. What's wrong? 1.1 ounces of sesame. I can't hold that much in the bowl. Whatever. Upgrade the bowl? I don't think I can. Get a bigger bowl. Okay, so this is puppet's bread. What kind of bread is puppet's bread? Is it a baguette? Croissant? What kind of bread is that? Is it long bread? No, you idiot. Whatever, this batch sucks. I don't care. I just want a nice warm piece of bread right now. Just super crunchy. Is there a bread that I don't like? I'm trying to think if there's a bread I actually don't like. No, don't even put it in yet. I have two trays. All right, back to it. I need to make 9, right? Okay, so I need to make 5 more. Can I fit? Okay, I'm just gonna do a shitty batch. I don't care. We're gonna do 5. Yeah, we're gonna make a shitty batch. I'm just gonna cut this whole thing in half and whatever. It's gonna, the bread's gonna be a little stringy. I don't care. All right, wheat flour. What was that? Somebody just went like, psst. Okay, I don't want to go too hard here. That's fine. A little bit less water than usual. Okay, that's fine. A little bit less milk than usual. Okay. Salt is fine. Okay. Wait, pull that back. Okay, sugar. I'm gonna see if I can fit the rest of it. One ounce? Where is it? Oh, up here. Fuck, I can't fit it. Shit! How do I upgrade the bowl? I can't even put it. I can't just shove a bowl of milk into the oven. Although I'm gonna try. No, I can't. What if I just hold it like this? Will it cook? Fuck, I have to do it right. Just give me, I'm gonna do 2 or whatever, I don't care. I'll do 3 track, I can do 3 reliably. Yeah, buy more of this shit. That's fine. Okay, water. Okay, milk. Salt. Who's trying to get my attention behind me? Okay, sugar. Yeast. All right, now I can do the right sesame seeds, right? Am I feeding a shitload of birds? What the hell? Why do I, there's so many seeds in here? There's a lot. That's a lot of bird seed. Okay. Turn around. I broke it. This bread sucks. Baked milk. What would baked milk even be? It would, nothing would happen. It would just be, it would get hot. All right, if if you put milk and a little bit of yeast into the milk, what would happen? Okay, a little bit of, all right, what would happen if you did this? If you took milk, yeast, and sugar, and you put them together and baked it, what would happen? You just put it in an oven-safe bowl and put it in the oven. What would happen? It would just be custard? It would just be flavorless, flourless cheese? This flour and cheese? It would just be sour. Would it? It would be cheese. Isn't cheese a much different process, though? Those of you asking why I'm doing this is to be able to get 9 of them. What the fuck are you talking about? I thought I was going to be able to split them. It wouldn't be cheese, no. Oh, that one's ugly. Whatever. They don't even care. I still got 80%, guys. This is, whatever. I'm gonna take them out anyways. I have to wait. I still have 12 minutes. What hair gel do you use? I don't use hair gel. I don't put any product in my hair. Ever. All right, come on, let's go. Liar, that's not a lie. I shampoo and condition, but that's it. No, I don't put hair gel in my hair. Do you know why I don't put any product in my hair? Because all the way from when I was a teenager up until my late 20s, anytime I put hair gel in my hair, I would get this, it didn't matter if it was, oh, you gotta get a different brand, you gotta get this brand, you gotta use a pomade, don't use that, use mousse, didn't matter what I did. Use a lot, don't use that much, use a little, it doesn't matter. I would get this line right here, this line of acne, that, because it would just get kind of greasy and sweaty and I hated it. And I'd get this line of pimples and acne. So I just started saying, I'm going to use a really good conditioner, really good shampoo, like very, very high quality, and go from there. And I don't put anything in my hair. I'm missing two. All right, two. Where's the bowl? All right, two more breads. Gonna be cold, but they'll get it. Okay, let's go. I mean, plus my hair is kind of wavy anyway, so I don't really need to put that nothing in my hair. My hair will naturally just go swoop, swoop, swoop. Baked milk. Baked milk might be better for you. It's good for people with intestinal issues. Holy shit, okay. Alright, water. What song was that? song was that one? It was Super Mario. Sorry, you got it wrong. Alright, where's the... What the fuck is going on? This one will be normal. This one's gonna be good. It's alright, 2.6, 2.5, 2.52, 2.48, 2.44, 2.4. That's what I did. All right. I can probably start putting these away. What? Excuse me. Puppets bun? Puppets bread. What's the difference? Puppets bread, puppets bun. I mean, these ones got bacteria growing on them anyways. That's annoying. Oh my god, I'm about to quit the game. I'm gonna quit the game. All right, well, let me see if I can... How many do I have in here? So it's not a lot... So it would be a round bread. This is correct, right? This would be a puppet bun. I only have enough for two? How do I only have enough for two? Bro, I don't know. Fringe fail baker. This is not even accurate. This is puppet's bread still. How do I make a bun? What? Bagels, croissants, baguettes, long breads. Oh my. It's literally right there. Oh my god, that's annoying. Just put it back on here and we'll redo it. Just reform it. Holy shit, I think I have enough to do it. I have enough to do it. This is saved. No, I have enough to do it. I have 6 minutes, but I should be okay. How many is that? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right, that's 9. Go. Puppets, but these are buns. How are these still? I don't understand. That's buns. I just chopped them into buns and I formed them into buns. I don't care. Those are literally buns. Go to the clipboard. What's happening? Who's that? Oh, I was like, who the fuck is this? Three puppets alone in the dark? I was like, who is this? I didn't accept the recipe? So what can I... I'm so confused. Self-made tasks. All right, whatever. I'll start over. I only have 4 minutes. It's over. Just quit. Just redo it. Somebody just walked in with a fucking pan and went like right in the back of my head. And I just went to black. Okay, $700. Let's go. Okay. Three farmer's loaf. All right. Farmer's loaf. You got it. What do I need? I can do this one. All right. 2.4. My eye. 2.4. That's a lot of water. I'm gonna run out of money. Oh, fuck off. Okay, good. Alright, rye flour. 1.8 pounds of rye flour. Okay, sourdough starter. You put a pint of this? What? I thought it was just like baking soda. I didn't think it was something else. What's in this? I need to buy more of this shit. Okay. I thought it was baking soda. It's ridiculously hard to get right. Do I have no money? Oh. Do you guys have any experience making sourdough? Alright, 1.4 ounces of salt. I'll get it right first try. Alright, only 15 seconds in the mixer. You have to put bugs in it. I don't think you do. Okay, then this is bake for 70 seconds at... did I spill any? Oh, what? I don't just bake it, I have to form it. All right, what is a farmer's loaf? What's a farmer's loaf? Is it a long bread? I hope that's right. I need three. How the fuck is this not... Yeah, that's two. And one little tiny shitty one. Dude, I could go for a huge pretzel right now. You know what? Honestly, a big, crunchy, hot pretzel. This might shock some of you. Might be... the single greatest food item that's ever been invented by humans. It really actually could be. If I really sit here and I really think about it. That could be the greatest tasting, greatest thing in the world. In the whole world. Golf sucks. Yeah, it does. Why do you think I'm going to disagree with you on that? Donuts are better? No, they're not. No, a pretzel, a nice, hot, soft pretzel with a thing of honey mustard or spicy mustard or even like cheese, nacho cheese or something. Or just straight up right out of the oven. Just a little bit of salt on it. Oh my god, pizza's perfect. Yeah. A really good pizza. I don't think it makes me have a child's palate. I think, oh man, the best steak I've ever had in my life. The best steak, no. I would rather take the best pizza I've ever had in my life over the best steak I've ever had in my life. Also, I'd rather have the best piece of salmon I've ever had in my life over the best steak I've ever had in my life. Steak is overrated. It just really, I don't know. I really just think it is. I genuinely believe that. I know it's really good, it is, but I kind of think it's overrated. Pizza and salmon pog. When I have a really nice piece of meat. Oh wow, dude, this is like ribeye, or this is Wagyu, is whatever. I've had it before. It's like, that was really good. But it's not good enough for me to care that much, to me. I think it's incredibly, it is, it's very good. But I don't know. The best piece of fish I've ever had is higher than the best piece of steak I've ever had. But then it's not even a red meat thing for me, because, okay, I love cheeseburgers. I love steak and cheese subs, steak bomb, right? I love meatballs. I love red meat, but I don't like the red meat where the red meat is just, hey, eat it. It's just a piece of red meat on a plate. No, I don't like that. Mm-mm. It needs more. It needs to be, there's gotta be something else there. Season it. You know what I mean? I'm just not into the whole, all right, I got a steak, and then there's broccoli and mashed potatoes on the plate too. Even with a bunch of good seasoning or a marinade or whatever. Garlic herb butter? Yeah, it's phenomenal. It's phenomenal, you're right. But I've had a piece of salmon before that I'm not kidding. And look, you can say this about a steak you had too, but I've never. I've had a piece of salmon before. I don't remember the restaurant. I genuinely don't remember. I do not know. It was in the North End in Boston. And I seriously thought that it felt like God came down and talked to me for like 10 minutes. It was just, it came out. It was no bullshit. It was just this delicious, fresh piece of salmon, and the fork, it was sitting on, I think, a piece of asparagus, whatever the hell it was. And I remember taking my fork, and I went to go touch it, and the whole thing disintegrated. It was just like, blah, blah, blah. I was like, what the holy sh-. So then you fork off a little bit, and by the time it hit my lips, right here, it was like cotton candy. It was just like, oh, it was like cotton candy. Didn't taste like cotton candy, but it acted like that. It was just gone. And I remember just going like this. I dropped the fork. I went like ding, 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 ding. And I was with my family, and I was just like, I don't know. I don't even know what I can say about that. Ratatouille. Did you eat cat food? Whatever. It was so good. And I remember when the waiter came over, I remember just, and you do this, by the way. If you really do like something, I'm serious, please start doing this. If you eat something at a restaurant and you go, that was actually really, really well made and really well done. That was fantastic. That was unbelievable. Tell the waiter. Go, hey, tell whoever's back there that was fucking phenomenal. That was phenomenal. And they should be proud of that. They should be absolutely proud of what they did. I'm serious. And then they go back there, they say, hey, the salmon at table 4, they were like, that was the best salmon they've ever had. You know what I mean? Like, they need to know that. They've got to know. That's not Ratatouille. Wouldn't Ratatouille be if I hated food and hated the restaurant or something? From a chef that makes our day. Yeah, and guess what? If you know that somebody is eating your food and they think it's like one of the best things they've ever had in their life, that's gonna be like, all right, let's go. Let's go. You like that salmon? You should try my catfish. Give that a try. I've got a risotto on this menu. It's gonna be good. Did you ask for the chef's number? No. Okay, so let's go. What am I doing? What about, that's a rich person restaurant. No. Some of the best food that I've had has come from places that were not expensive. It's the person behind the goddamn curtain. Don't you understand? It's the person behind the curtain. I've been to really expensive restaurants and the food sucked absolute asshole. I've been to restaurants where you'd go, holy shit, that's how much the entrees are? And it's some of the best food I've had in a long time. It's the person behind the curtain. That's a weird flex. Guys, I've been to McDonald's that are better than some five-star restaurants I've been to. I'm telling you, this is my real take. The way that I feel biting into a double cheeseburger from McDonald's and how delicious it is, and then eating, oh, this is a pan-seared freaking fish steak with tuna glazed roe on it, and it has a piece of parsley all over it, and it's I don't like this. I've eaten stuff like that before, and I've had stuff like that that was very good, and I've had stuff like that that's very bad. Would you ever eat a snake? No. Nice child's palate. I know for a fact that there are people in this chat right now that have eaten at McDonald's and had a five-star restaurant like filet mignon and went, that one sucked. That was not that great. That actually was kind of not good. I know for a fact you've done it. I'm positive. I know for a fact that you've been sitting in the back of a car that went to the drive-thru and you were eating fries out of the bag, sneaking them. Just eating fries out of the bag. You went with a bunch of friends, whatever. And you enjoyed that more than the like a tuna tartare that you had at a four-star restaurant before. I know it. Don't pull one over on me. And by the way, why are you eating tuna tartare? Why are you eating steak tartare? What's wrong with you? Somebody on the phone right now that called the restaurant.
I mean, I ordered 3 pieces of farmer's loaf. Is that coming, or?
At this delivery, I've already burnt 5 minutes. Tuna tartare is sushi. All right, yeah, no, that's right. Steak tartare, though. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I don't understand why people do that. I don't understand why people do that. I don't get it. What is it? Tell me what it is about it. Steak tartare is but tell me why. Tell me why. Why are there so many viewers? I don't know. Wait, okay, so wait, somebody called me an idiot. Hold on. Somebody said you're a fucking idiot. Why? But why? Somebody said, why? Oh, why do you say tartare like that, you fucking idiot? I thought you were calling me an idiot because you liked tartare and you were giving me a reason why. How am I saying it wrong? Steak tartare. Tartare, how do you say it? That's how you say it. Tartare? Tartare. 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 What? Are you guys full? I'm saying it right. That's correct. Steak tartare.
Steak tartare.
Okay, thank you.
Steak tartare.
One more time for everybody that was listening.
Steak tartare.
How do you pronounce steak tartare correctly? It's a regional thing? Oh, I have an ad.
We are looking at how to pronounce this name as well as how to say more interesting French cooking terms too that many get wrong, so make sure to stay tuned for those.
Okay, this is the real deal.
This is a meat dish made from raw ground beef. Some say it can also be made from horse, even though even in France that's really not very common. Anyhow, how do you say it? For reference, in French, in France it is said as steak tartare.
Oh, steak come tartare. On!
Therefore, in English, it is generally said as steak tartare.
And that, by the way, this is directly from Iwin. Iwin. Steak tartare. Steak tartare. That's what I said. Why are people so mean to me? Okay. That was 11 minutes, by the way. The guy on the phone is still there. Dude, I don't care about steak tartare, dude. I mean, you've got like a 5-star review, so I'm gonna sit here and wait for the bread. But, are you alright? Alright, let's go. Track it. What am I even doing? French is not a real language. Okay. What does that mean? All right. Bronze bread, 4. Let's go. Why are we... what? 5 pounds of rye flour. Is this going to be too much? I understand... okay, raw... I understand raw food. Like, raw fish, right? I understand it. But something about raw hamburger meat... Raw hamburger meat smells. It has this smell to it. Kind of like I talked about with raw eggs. I don't want to eat that. And it's not ground beef. What do you mean? It's a hamburger meat. It's raw meat. What do you mean? It's not... Yeah, all right, I get it. You're not going to the grocery store and getting a pound of ground beef and eating it raw with a fork, okay? Hold on. Hold that thought. Yeast, okay. Salt. Sugar. Whoa, too much. It's the natural way of eating it. I don't like it. And I'm not even saying it needs to be well done. I'm just saying it needs to be cooked. All right, but honestly, who started cooking food? Why did we start cooking food then? Right? Like, who started cooking food? Cavemen? So you're telling me that the cavemen were like,
raw meat. Yes.
And then all of a sudden they put it over a fire. And then went,
good, 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 good.
And they all started fucking screaming. They decided that. We didn't. The only reason why we do this now is because the cavemen decided to burn a warthog that they fucking found in the forest. What was this again? I don't remember. All right, bronze bread, and it's just a regular brown bread. We started cooking food. Hold on, somebody's got the answer. Actually, I'm very curious about this. I really am. I swear to God. Cooking food allowed us to get more nutrients out of it, so people who cooked food survived more than those that didn't. We started cooking food because our teeth became less sharp, and we also didn't want to die of diseases. You English major. Different people do different specialties, and that's what I need to know every single thing. I have to be a doctor, an English teacher, a scientist, and an astronaut. People do different things. But to me, it tastes better. Like a medium, even like medium rare, right? I medium to medium rare, medium. To me, just that tastes better to me than just eating it raw. And we add, you know, garlic and butter and flavors and parsley and... Oh, I want one now. Bro, this is high school knowledge. Yeah? That's what the cavemen thought too. You know how many people? It's crazy to think about this, honestly. The flavors that we like over thousands and thousands and thousands of years. Cavemen were just going and picking up berries and squishing them and putting them on their steak and eating it. And just dying.
Like, no, no. No, don't eat us.
It's crazy. Like, I'm wondering the first person to piss on the fire.
Pee, piss on fire. No, I don't know. I don't know about that. Yes, yeah, flavor.
And then they ate that guy. Where's my bread? They didn't start making bread until... pee on food. Yeah, they had to be away. You would eat a person? No, I'm saying that. Maybe, I don't know. I wouldn't, I'm just saying it back a fucking million years ago. Guys, they didn't have the McDonald's drive-thru. No, I don't know. You don't know what it was like a million years ago. Nice granddad joke. You guys are fucking so funny. But yeah, they probably put so much gross shit all over their food. Can you imagine how disgusting food probably was for a long time? That's for us to complain. Oh, excuse me. This drink is a little too sweet. Redo it. They had steak tartare, though, and I'm sure it was good. That's literally you. I actually don't complain about food if it's wrong. I really don't. Okay, it has to be very, very wrong. Very wrong. You know how much of a pain in the ass it is to deal with a shitload of people? You know what's crazy? Here we go. Okay, everyone, hold on. Here comes a take. The amount of people that you see in, let's say, like a McDonald's drive-thru, think of how crazy it gets at a lot of these places. There are sometimes 10 plus 20 cars for hours outside of these McDonald's restaurants or Burger King, it doesn't matter. It's... oh no, you! I wanted a Sprite and you gave me a Coke. Okay. That's all right. Like, whatever. That's not a big deal to me. It really isn't. Now, if I ordered, you know, 2 double cheeseburgers, a fry, and a Coke, and I got 3 chicken sandwiches, a McFlurry, and like, this is not my order. This is not even close. Like, I'll be like, oh, hey, this it's no problem at all, but this is probably somebody else's order. All right, what's next? What's coming up? What am I even on? Okay, wait, didn't I do this? Wow, that's a great take. That really wasn't a take, really. Now that you're right. That actually wasn't a take. What was the take? I just said, that's fucking crazy. That's not a take. Hey, dude, that's crazy. All right, let's move on. The take is I don't complain. Oh, that's right. Well, no. My take is that, all right, here's the take. That a lot of people that work in the fast food industry have to deal with a lot of horse shit. And I don't want to be one of those people that adds to the stress of, like, a bunch of people fucking screaming at them through the intercom and, like, fucking with them through the, like, you know, like, fucking with them. And it's a lot of bullshit. So, I don't know. I try to... And why can't we tip at the fucking window? Some places they can't. No, we can't. We can't do that. Not saying that, like, you know, obviously people, you know, tipping is a whole nother can of worms, right? But a lot of places you can't. Why do we have to tip? Yeah, I know. It's a confusing. And it's like, the worker is relying on your tip because they're just not getting paid to be there at a wage that's a reasonable fucking wage, right? So it's like, is it 20%? Is it 15%? Is it 40%? 30%? Is it 12%? What if I do 15%? Is that bad? What's wrong? What did you do? What's your tip? Are we doing tips together? Should we give 50? Should I give $100? I'm going to give $100. Should I give 10? I get it. I do. But I will also be honest too, though, I do like to, if somebody's, you know, really nice and they do a good job and it's like, you know, you're actually, you're working your ass off here. Fuck it, I'll give you, why not? I get it. But that's on me, right? That's on the individual. Yeah. Really doing a good job placing these trays over and over again. But, and sometimes tipping gets weird because how expensive was the meal, right? Where it gets weird. Technically, we paid for the tip. Yeah. You know, also too, like a lot of times tipping, if the restaurant just paid the, and you know, you think about what your check would be, right? Let's say your check is $20 or $30, $40. The extra money that you'd be tipping, I don't know, there's probably some mathematician or economist in here, but like, if you took away the tipping, and even if you needed to charge a little more for the food, I'm not paying potentially more to tip and pay for the food. And you could pay potentially the workers better, right? Can an economist tell me that here? Even if you made the food more expensive by enough, but it didn't reach that point where it was the tip on top of it, right? Run a restaurant, then you get back to me. I'm talking out my ass. I know. Am I gonna make bread or what? All right, stop. I can literally do one thing at a time. All right, four. I need. By the way, I'm moving. I'm gonna play a different game after this. This game's fun, but I'm gonna do something else. This game's relaxing. This is a very nice, relaxing game to play. Shit. Make another bread apology? I haven't had any bread. Okay. 8 ounces of olive oil, 0.8 ounces of yeast. Looks good. 8 of salt. Looks good. 32 of sugar. Whoa, one? Oh, okay. Man, that's so wrong. How would you suck it out with a vacuum? Imagine taking like a nozzle and just... Yeah, I took out enough sugar. We're good. Okay. Go. Just scrape it off. Scrape it out. Go back to Morrowind? Jerma, can you talk about... No. All right. The whole thing is not to start arguments in chat. The whole point is to just tell you how I feel. You started it. I know. I know. I started it. I did. You didn't say anything, though. Yeah, you know what? Fuck that. I didn't say anything. I agree with that guy. That was bad. How do I feel about lizards? I love lizards. And I never got exposed to them really or experienced them at all because they're not really on the East Coast where I lived. There's not very many lizards running around Massachusetts. I mean, there are some, but not like there are out here. They're everywhere out here. Oh, come on. Alright, this is the last delivery, and then I'm gonna play... Should I play that Choose Your Own Adventure thing that Kyle's famous? Is that any good? I wanted to play it. I heard it's good. I'll try it. I can't even upgrade this stuff. When do I get to upgrade? Five Nights at Freddy's 2. Kyle is Famous had 2 votes in pre-stream chat. Yeah, but I mean, it still seems like a fun game. Let's go. Five Nights at Freddy's 2? You don't actually want me to do that. Do you actually want me to play Five... All right, mods, do a poll. This has to have 80% yeses or I'm not doing it. By the way, this needs 80% yeses and it needs at least 5,000 responses. At least 5K responses, at least. Oh, come on. I can't see where I'm going. We're good. Oh my god. Where is this? It's not across the bridge, okay. Did I just drive into a police car? Alright, what's it look like? You got 5,000. Nope, not moving. Sorry. It needed to be 80%. Nope. Close. All right, so let's do what else do I got? We could do My Time at Portia. Portia. That's a game that I had open all last stream. We could do Kyle is Famous. I got a few things we have. All right, well, I'm gonna go pee. I'll be right back. We'll figure it out. Get some water. Well, I have some here, but I go pee. I'll probably fix the camera too. Looks like shit. All right, I'll be back. Talk amongst yourselves. BRB.
You know what else I want to do?
Hi, sorry if I startled you.
The whole wrestling, hey, what song is this thing? Does anybody know? Do you remember when we did that video game sound effect thing? Where I had to figure out what game it was from or what character did it? From, oh, here's a sound effect. And what is that? What's that from? Are there more of those? I want to do one of those. Is there a good one? There are a few more of those. If any of you guys know any, or mods, if you can get me a good one. One that I haven't done. That would be fun to do. It's Sporkle? Yeah, it would have to be something that can play sound effects through the browser. What's Sporkle? Let me look this up. Sporkle? It's just a trivia site? No, I don't want to do trivia. I want to do sound effects, and then I have to guess what the sound is.
Okay.
It looks like Kyle is Famous has won, so I'm going to open it. Give some time to maybe get a couple of these fun websites. This game's loud. All right, play. What you're describing is no, but it's not trivia though. Trivia would be this plumber back in 1985 or 1983 got his start jumping on Goombas, and it'd be, oh, okay, that's, I know that. Let me see what it is. Search it up on Sporkle, you piece of shit. Sporkle is based and Pog. Okay, all right, hold on. Do they have what I'm describing? Hold on. I want to find the one that I want to find. Hold on. They do? They have that. All right, okay. Sporkle is cracked. Do I need an account? Wait, what? Is this for real? Okay, hold on a second. I have to turn off ad blocker. Okay. Hold on. I guess it is? Play quiz? Hold on. Hurdle? You should do hurdle. All right, here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna play Kyle is Famous. The stream's gonna be not 2 hours long, guys. We'll get a couple of good ones, but I gotta do something. We'll curate a few. All right, I'm back. I need to capture this. Uh-huh. There it is. Okay.
So this is a choose-your-own-adventure game where you have to make decisions. You have to make choices. I said I was going to fix the camera, but I didn't. Okay. Here we go. Somebody said they went to McDonald's, they enjoyed the double cheeseburger and the four-piece nuggets that they ordered. So I thought I would follow Jerma's advice and offer my thanks to the chef. The lady at the register just stared at me like I had two heads. Oh, come on.
Kyle woke up.
This is voice acted.
He is famous.
Okay. Sure. Tell me if it's too loud.
Kyle is host of the most popular talk show in recent memory, Stay Up Late with Kyle.
Okay. Were my choices?
Stay Up Late with Kyle has grown in popularity quickly in the last year, and the public has noticed.
Okay.
Inside has called Kyle a most excellent dumpy white man.
All right. Cool.
Top Tech noted that Kyle is inspiring youth to explore STEM fields.
Is this all is this AI? Is this randomly generated?
Most other talk shows are dedicated to discussing Kyle and his personal details.
This has to be randomly generated, right?
Most online videos are best of clips taken from Kyle's latest broadcast.
Okay.
The eye of the world is upon Kyle.
Okay.
Tonight is Kyle's most important guest interview yet.
All right.
Stay Up Late with Kyle will be featuring Rachel May. She is a kind and lovely philanthropist.
Oh, I have to click on this?
She is dear
no,
to
I don't.
The hearts of many. This interview requires preparation.
Okay, wait, what did I missed? No, we're good.
Kyle cracked his eyes open, knowing today is his last chance to prepare for the interview.
Okay, so I got a show, I got to prepare for the interview, I got an interview to do, let's go.
Kyle has 30 hours left. He must choose his actions wisely.
Okay. Okay, first decision of the morning was made wisely. Wither away or exit the bed? I mean, we're going to exit the bed. Kyle exited his bed and took a quick glance around his bedroom. Scavenge.
Kyle quickly crouched down on the floor, realizing his immediate need for...
Bugs.
Kyle started to pick between the fuzz of his bedroom carpet, hoping to catch a stray beetle or two.
Okay.
Soon, he had a small handful of various insects, dead and alive.
I eat them.
Kyle threw back his head and crammed the sticky, wriggling mass into his mouth. He felt refreshed.
I did that for 5 hours? Wait, hold on. There's a system in this game where, all right, I've been doing that for 6 hours. All right, open the closet. It was dark and he could only really see his hanging shirts. Choose an outfit.
Kyle decided to take some time to choose the perfect outfit.
Oh, some of this is active and some isn't.
How important appearance is.
Suit of armor.
Kyle was unsure of what exactly caused him to decide to wear his armor, but it felt like the right thing to do.
Okay.
After much squeezing and sweating, Kyle managed to wrap the metal suit around his dumpy self.
Which would be hard. I get it. Trust me. Alright, sit at the desk. Write notes for the interview.
Kyle wrote down his first question.
Are you a mother?
Kyle wrote down his second question.
You ever eaten a raw whole egg? Sure.
Kyle wrote down his third question.
What's your funniest story?
Kyle wrote down his last question.
What's your guilty pleasure?
Kyle ripped his page of notes out of the notebook and got up from the desk.
Okay. Am I wasting time here? Should I not be doing this? All right, open the side drawer of his desk and grab one of the items stored there. A key.
Kyle grabbed the small key he kept in his desk.
Cool. This is not Bakery Simulator anymore. No, it's not. What about use the key?
Oh, yeah, get the change, too.
Kyle scooped up the change, scattered around.
All right, so let's go. Back to the room. I did everything. Let's go. Okay, we have to exit. I only have 4 hours. I think I have to leave. Check the locked door.
Kyle walked over to the strange door in the hallway, but found quickly that the door was locked.
I've been walking around eating bugs and sitting in... it's been 30 hours. I have to leave. Leave apartment. Visit the tech store. Buy batteries with change. I can do that. Okay, now what?
Kyle hurried to the set. Sitting across from his host chair was a glamorous woman with an air of genuinity. As Kyle approached her, Rachel looked up and smiled.
Okay.
Good evening, Kyle, she said, looking him in the eyes. I've been looking forward to being here.
Last second batteries, that's right.
Kyle responded.
Well, this is the funny, this is the funny answer, so we're gonna do the regular answer.
And I as well, Rachel, answered Kyle, extending his hand in greeting. You are a most welcome guest.
Shake hands.
After other mild exchanges of pleasantries, Kyle and Rachel were prompted to take their places for the broadcast.
Okay.
A moment after seating, the studio lights brightened and the cameras clicked on.
Start broadcast.
Good evening, everyone, said Kyle, looking at the camera. Welcome back to Stay Up Late with Kyle. Kyle vomited all of the horrible things he had eaten earlier onto the floor. Rachel looked at Kyle, concerned, gave a couple coughs, and decided to play it cool and keep the show running. Kyle stopped, then vomited again, then continued with a shaky voice.
Tonight, I have the pleasure of interviewing the lovely Rachel May, who needs no more introduction.
Kyle motioned to Rachel, who smiled and waved at the camera.
Hello, Kyle, she said. I'm glad to be here.
Well, he finally fixed your mic. We'll have a lot to discuss. So we might as well dive right in,
finally,
said Kyle.
All right, let's go.
I'm very ready, said Rachel with a winning smile.
How can I just draw?
Kyle produced the notes he had taken earlier.
All right, you ever eaten a whole egg?
Hey, Rachel, ever eaten a raw egg whole? Asked Kyle.
Like shell and all? Asked Rachel.
Kyle continued.
I like a lot. It's really bad though, so sometimes I spit it back up.
You guys probably hear my mouth going like.
There was a silence. It actually gets easier the more you do it, continued Kyle without losing momentum. So don't start, I say.
Rachel chose not to.
Where the fuck do we end up? Where are we?
I think the story I always remember is the first time I tried to make dinner for my family.
Okay.
In the soup I made, I swapped out the water with milk and tipped the whole jar of salt in the pot. While my family was sick from trying to eat it, I swiped their things and locked myself in my room.
Okay.
Rachel laughed elegantly. Kyle decided to move on. Kyle asked another question.
What's your guilty pleasure?
We all have one. What's your guilty pleasure?
Hold on, let me do this right. You need to be able to see the microphone. Then I gotta be like this. Hey, ready?
Ooh, well, that's an easy answer, said Rachel, dipping pickles in chocolate sauce. It might sound strange, but it's tangy and sweet at the same time. I eat it far too often.
Rachel smiled sweetly. After reading his final question, Kyle looked up from his paper.
Well, Rachel, he said,
I think that's all I was planning on asking you.
If that's the case, Kyle, may I ask you something in return?
Asked Rachel, smiling one more time.
Why exactly did you decide to wear a suit of armor today?
Before Kyle could answer, the camera shut down. The broadcast was over. Kyle returned home, knowing the interview had gone well. But as he lay in bed and drifted to sleep, he felt that, perhaps, something was still missing?
Did I lose? He's moving like a TikToker. I'm having fun doing this. Can I do the I'm doing the voices thing still? Is this still funny to you? That was the most unfunny bit. That's welcome. Okay. I'm gonna do it one more time. Okay, one more time, that's it. I'm gonna get really animated.
Kyle hurried to the set. Sitting across from his host chair was a glamorous woman with an air of genuinity. As Kyle approached her, Rachel looked up and smiled.
Good evening, Kyle, she said, looking him in the eyes. I've been looking forward to being here.
Kyle responded. Kyle stretched his arms wide, tilted his neck upwards, and was interrupted by his producer telling him and Rachel that it was time to start the show. Kyle shoved his producer out of the way, spread his arms wide, and began to scream loudly. He began to rotate slowly, screaming throughout, lightly brushing his hands against the faces of Rachel and his producer. After several minutes, Kyle was finished. He slowly put his hands to his sides and smiled. I'm ready, said Kyle. Rachel blinked at Kyle, shrugged, and walked over to her seat. A moment after seating, the studio lights brightened and the cameras clicked on. Good evening, everyone, said Kyle, looking at the camera. Welcome back to Stay Up Late with Kyle. Kyle vomited all of the horrible things he had eaten earlier onto the floor. Rachel looked at Kyle, concerned, gave a couple coughs, and decided to play it cool and keep the show running. Kyle stopped, then vomited again, then continued with a shaky voice.
Tonight, I have the pleasure of interviewing the lovely Rachel May, who needs no more introduction.
Kyle motioned to Rachel, who smiled and waved at the camera.
Hello, Kyle, she said. I'm glad to be here.
Why would sound come out and I don't move my mouth? All right, I'm done. I'm done with this one. Fuck, I want to play this game, though. Let me just play it for a minute. Let me play the game for a minute. It's actually very well done voice acting.
Well, I'm sure we'll have a lot to discuss. So we might as well dive right in, said Kyle.
This is not bakery. No, this is not still bakery simulator. Wait, I'm still like voice. Hold on. This is the same person, the same guy that did Gabriel? Who did the bosses from Ultra Kill? Are you shitting me? I told you that fucking guy was talented. Alright, what happened? Why does this look so weird now? This looks... What happened? Oh, there we go, okay. Alright, I'm gonna play. I'm gonna play for like 10 minutes. Can I play? Leave me alone, I'm playing.
I'm very ready, said Rachel with a winning smile. Kyle produced the notes he had taken earlier.
Okay, I'm not starting with this. What's your guilty pleasure?
We all have one. What's your guilty pleasure?
Ooh, well, that's an easy answer, said Rachel, dipping pickles in chocolate sauce.
That's really not that weird.
It might sound strange, but it's tangy and sweet at the same time. I eat it far too often.
Rachel smiled sweetly.
People put all kinds of weird shit on pickles, okay?
Kyle asked another question.
All right, what's a funny story you have?
You've been involved in a lot of different things, said Kyle. But what's your funniest story?
Well, that's a great question, Kyle, said Rachel. I think the story I always remember is the first time I tried to make dinner for my family.
Okay.
In the soup I made, I swapped out the water with milk and tipped the whole jar of salt in the pot.
Ugh.
While my family was sick from trying to eat it, I swiped their things and locked myself in my room.
Oh, that's what I missed and I skipped.
Rachel laughed elegantly. Kyle decided to move.
Yeah, he moved on.
Kyle asked another question.
Are you a mother?
Rachel, I and many others
did I do something
would
wrong?
Love to know. Are you a mother?
Kyle.
Well, being a single woman with a career, she answered, that's not something that has crossed my mind.
Who is this again? Who is this? Who is this person?
Rachel smiled genuinely at Kyle.
Redo the whole game. Oh, right.
Very reasonable indeed, said Kyle. Kyle.
Okay, so yeah, then
hey,
the
Rachel,
interview's
ever
over.
Eat a raw egg whole? Asked Kyle.
Like shell and all?
Asked Rachel. Kyle continued.
I have. It's bad. Like, sometimes spit it back up.
There was a silence.
There was a silence.
It actually gets easier the more you
yep,
do it.
Yep, I remember this.
Rachel chose not to answer. After
okay.
reading. Well, Rachel.
Think it's all planning.
If that's
all
the
right.
case, Kyle, may I ask you something in return? Why exactly did you decide to wear a suit of armor today?
Okay.
Before Kyle
what
could
the
answer,
fuck?
The camera shut down. Kyle returned.
All right, I screwed the whole thing up. I'm going back. Repeat. Reset. No.
Kyle hurried.
No. I screwed it up.
As Kyle approached her, Rachel looked up and smiled.
Okay, here we go. I'm gonna wither away.
Kyle decided to stay put and wither away.
I wasted way too
Kyle
much time.
Kyle withered successfully and died.
Wait, what? That's it?
Kyle is now a ghost. This does not relieve him of his responsibilities.
Oh, okay. All right, so what do I need from here? I'm going to choose an outfit.
Kyle decided to take some time to choose the perfect outfit,
okay.
knowing
I'm
how
wear the suit.
Important appearance is. Kyle miraculously crammed his dumpy body into the suit. The chest pockets were filled with random knickknacks.
Okay. So now, I think I'm going to leave. Wait, sit at the desk and get the batteries, right? Change.
Kyle scooped
right,
up the change.
Get out. Okay. Move to the kitchen. Open the fridge.
Kyle opened the fridge, intending to find something to eat.
Eat crust on the fridge wall. Eat the fridge. How do you eat? You can't eat the fridge. Can I? No, I would eat condiments. That'll get, like, all the gross, I didn't brush my teeth yet, out of my mouth. If there's one thing that will cover that up, it's a bottle of ketchup.
Kyle started to grab condiments from the fridge, squirting them into his mouth with both hands.
Okay.
ketchup, horseradish, and mayonnaise entered Kyle's mouth at a rate that soon overwhelmed his ability to swallow.
That actually sounds good. I'm not kidding.
Kyle spewed the excess condiment slurry across the kitchen, covering the furniture and walls.
Okay.
Kyle continued until all of the condiments had been emptied.
Not to eat by itself, but just put that on something. Like, that doesn't sound like a bad combo. Alright, I got 10 hours. Check the pantry.
Kyle wanted to access the pantry, but found it was locked with a small keyhole.
Mayo, horseradish, and ketchup. That's probably... Horseradish is delicious with anything. And ketchup and mayonnaise is just Thousand Island dressing. So it's just Thousand Island with a little bit of kick to it. What makes that... What's the problem with that? Alright, the key is for the pantry. But Thousand Island sucks. Big Mac sauce, yeah.
Kyle wanted to...
Alright, yeah, I can. Alright, so let's go back to the hallway. I only have a few... You gotta get out of the house immediately. Oh, I can haunt.
Kyle felt a sudden pull on his heart. Had he abandoned his job as a ghost? Was he fulfilling his spooky, ethereal role that he'd accepted while lying in bed this morning? Kyle realized he had no other choice. He must spend his day spooking about.
Okay.
Kyle decided he should make a plan about who or where he should spook.
At the interview.
Kyle thought that it would be best to continue his daily course.
That makes sense.
But with a twist. Today, he would still go to his studio, but instead of conducting an interview, he would haunt.
Thousand Island is incredible. Yeah, I don't. What are you guys talking? Thousand Island is good on lots of stuff.
Excitedly, Kyle made his way to the studio early to find the best spot to conduct his ghostly duties.
I don't love Thousand Island dressing, but I don't hate it.
The studio was empty. Being so early, the crew wouldn't arrive for several hours.
Okay.
Kyle gleefully skipped around the building, finding the best spot for himself to hide.
Okay.
After searching for some time, Kyle decided to hide behind the guest chair.
Okay. Rubens, yep.
Kyle
yeah.
quickly placed himself down and drew his legs to his chest.
Wait,
soon,
like...
the crew began to arrive and set up for the interview that night. Invisible to all senses, Kyle went undetected. He watched as cameras were set up, screens were turned on, and pages were flipped. Within an hour, Rachel walked into the studio.
This is it.
Hey, everyone, said Rachel, smiling kindly. I'm ready to get prepped. Who do I need to talk to first?
Kyle's producer approached her.
Thanks for being here, Rachel. You should really talk to Andre about makeup first, and then wait for when Kyle arrives.
Here I come.
Kyle, knowing he was duping everyone, began to giggle uncontrollably.
He's doing a little bit of trolling. Yeah, well, I'm doing a little bit of trolling.
It was
whatever.
Then that he, like clockwork, ceased to be a ghost.
Why?
The studio grew silent. Everyone stared at Kyle, head down, clutching his legs and giggling at the floor.
What is TF?
Kyle froze. He had found himself in a situation he had not encountered before. Kyle started to crawl out of the studio on all fours, hoping his small form
Troll
would avoid
face?
Attracting oh. more attention.
Why can I not see that?
Everyone wordlessly watched as Kyle slowly made his way across the stage, through the production set, and out the door. As soon as he was outside the studio, Kyle broke into an all-out sprint.
I still have money.
Kyle made his way back to his apartment as quickly as possible. Kyle sat in his kitchen and processed what had happened during his day.
Am I still dead?
He vowed that he would never haunt anything again.
How many endings are there? Dude, Kyle is literally me. How we do? We got. Oh, we got. We have the wrestling one. Should I try the wrestling quiz? I feel like I would do pretty good on it. All right, let me get it. I'll try it. I can't promise that I'm going to do well, but I think I'll get probably half of these. You have a reptilian brain? Okay, Sporkle. Let's get it. How do I do this? Tic-tac trivia? Oh, this is, wait, there's a lots of six-letter word in 1980s songs? Okay. Television cakes? This looks fun. Pick that movie. This looks fun. This is fun, isn't it? What's pick that movie? Dude, let's go. Pick that movie? Hold on. How does it work? Let's pick that movie. Can you pick the movie that fits each clue? All right, I'm excited. All right, hold on. Let me get this set up. The movie quiz. Okay. How do I, where is it? Let me close this. So, the 100 people left. That's all right, it's fine. Where the fuck is this window? I have so much trouble capturing windows on stream. It never seems to work the way that I want it to. Where is it? I can see it in my preview, but I can't. Hold on. Okay. It should be there. Come on, I want to play. It won't show up. I can see it in the preview, but I can't see it actually on the window. You're doing your best, yeah. Make it work. I'm trying. What do you think I'm doing? There it is. So what the fuck? OBS, what are you doing? It says it's got it. I don't get it. I'll try it again. Hello, it's my birthday. Someone help Dad. I should be pulling this. It's just not. Come on! What the heck? Hold on. Let me see if I can do this. Every time this happens, I have to restart OBS. And I really don't want to do that. I might have to, though, because I think it's frozen.